Hello and I welcome you all to your own YouTube channel Atlantean. The topic for today, as you have already seen, is flammability diagram. Now let us discuss one thing before we dive deep into this topic. Suppose you want to cross a highway or an expressway and you keep your eyes blindfolded. Now what are the chances that you will survive, or what are the chances that you will reach the other end safely? It is a matter of luck, isn't it? But we all know luck is not a reliable friend. Similarly, when we are working on tankers, we cannot rely ourselves or our fate or our destiny to luck. And that is why we need to think, you know, coming to that expressway example or that highway example, we know that we are relying on other drivers' ability to stop their car if they see us blindfolded. But why are we not relying on our own eyes? Similarly, for flammability diagram, we would like to rely on our own knowledge and our own research which scientists have done, so that we can keep ourselves and our ships safe. So going by the word flammability, it comes from two words, flames plus ability. So it is an ability of substance to produce flame, or in simple word, it is an ability of substance to burn. Second is composition of air. Now why are we discussing these basics? Haven't we studied in school? Yes, we have studied in school. But a few basics here and there would help us understand the future concepts better, the concepts which we will be discussing in later in this video. So as you know, composition of air, the biggest element is nitrogen, which is 78%, oxygen is 20.9%, and remaining are other gases which consist of all your inert gas, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, etc., etc. Why does fire take place? What happens if I burn a wood, if I'm burning petrol, if I'm burning diesel or anything? The main composition is hydrocarbons. These are the organic substance which actually burns. This serve as a fuel. Most of the things which burn in our world consist of hydrocarbons and oxygen. Now, when these two things meet, see, it is not only these two. We have all studied what is fire triangle. So fire triangle, one side there is a heat or source of ignition. One is oxygen, one is fuel. Now this fuel is hydrocarbon. Heat or source of ignition is what we are afraid of. And oxygen is omnipresent in air. We cannot deny oxygen's present. And that is why it becomes important to study this flammability diagram, so that we can ensure that fire will not take place. Now coming to the next, what is flame speed? Now this will be very helpful for us when we go about too rich or too lean atmosphere. Flame speed, remember, if anything wants to sustain burning, if it wants to continue burning, minimum speed of the flame has to be 7 meters per second. This is the figure which I've discovered by scientists. So 7 meters per second is the minimum speed at which flame must travel in order to sustain the burning. Very, very important. Sometimes we know that oxygen is required for combustion, but what does oxygen do? Oxygen does nothing but a process called oxidation. And remember, all the oxidation reactions are generally exothermic in nature. Exothermic means they evolve huge amount of heat. Now let us study the role of oxygen. So I have taken, for example, methane gas combines with oxygen, releases carbon dioxide, releases water vapor, and it releases heat. Now if you see, all of them are in gaseous form, and this is one of the reason why the smoke comes out. It is nothing but the water or the steam which is evaporated in the process. For any combustion to take place, minimum amount of oxygen has to be 11%. Now in some places this figure is written as 11.5%, in some places it is 12, some places it is 11. So we will not go by the accuracy of the figure, we will go by the general idea, and we will consider the lowest possible figure, which is 11%. Since today's class is about flammability diagram, we will not go deep in pyrolysis, but if you want me to cover pyrolysis, we will cover it in some other class. Going further with our discussion, remember one thing. That flammability diagram concept is applicable to closed environment, closed spaces, for example tanks. And on tankers, we of course have got tanks, and that is why we are learning this concept. Now we have studied that minimum oxygen is 11% for combustion to take place. What about hydrocarbon? Hydrocarbon comes in two ranges. One is minimum, one other one is maximum. The minimum required hydrocarbon is 2% by volume. And इफ द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ हाइड्रोकार्बन इज लेस देन 2% बाय वॉल्यूम इट विल बी नोन एज टू लीन एंड द मैक्सिमम रिक्वायर्ड हाइड्रोकार्बन इज 10% बाय वॉल्यूम इफ इट इज मोर देन 10% इट इज कॉल्ड एज टू रिच एंड हियर वी वुड अंडरस्टैंड वन थिंग सिंस वी स्पोक अबाउट क्लोज्ड एनवायरमेंट वी कंसिडर अ टैंक ऑफ लिमिटेड वॉल्यूम वेयर नाइट्रोजन will be more or less fixed at 78%. So nitrogen has got its share of atmosphere. 78% by what? By volume. Now 78% being occupied by nitrogen, the fight usually occurs between the oxygen and the hydrocarbon. Consider this situation where hydrocarbon is greater than 10%. Let us say I'm taking a figure of 11%. Moment I have hydrocarbon is 11%, it will add up with this nitrogen and total concentration of nitrogen and hydrocarbon will become 89%, leaving only 11% space for O2, and we know that other gases are still 1%. So oxygen is technically 10%, fire will not take place because hydrocarbon is too rich. There is a lot of hydrocarbon and very little oxygen. Remember or recall the methane chemical reaction where each molecule of methane required two molecules of oxygen, and that is why the combustion will not take place if there is an excess of hydrocarbon. You can similarly prove that when your hydrocarbon is less than 2% by volume, other gases occupying their spaces, there's no fuel, there's not enough fuel to burn. What happens is, even if there is a spark or even if there is a fire, it will not sustain because 7 m/s flame speed criteria will not be complying because there is no hydrocarbon, or hydrocarbon are located in that closed atmosphere so far away that to reach or to have that 7 m/s speed requires lot of molecules of hydrocarbon. Fire is nothing but a chain reaction, and for the chain reaction the most important thing is chain. In this situation where you have hydrocarbon less than 2% by volume, there is not enough hydrocarbon, there is not enough chain or molecules of hydrocarbon to burn, and that is why we call it too lean. When it is more than 10%, the oxygen gets eaten up because of the nitrogen and other gases and this 11% of hydrocarbon, and that is why this atmosphere is also called as too rich. Now let us study this flammability diagram. So flammability diagram is a graphical representation of x-axis and y-axis, on like we have on all the graphs. On x-axis I've got oxygen content from 0 to 22 because it's being 1% higher than 21. On y-axis, that is the vertical axis, I've got hydrocarbon from 2%, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. Now recall that 2% to 10% range which I had given you, that is for methane gas. We have different percentage for different gases, but 2% and 10% is the standard set by ISGOT, which is International Safety Guide for Oil Tankers and Terminals. Now, this flammability diagram, having defined both the axes, first step or the easiest step is I will draw a vertical line at 11%. Because I know combustion on this side cannot take place, less than 11%, there will be no combustion. Once you have done this, what we do is, from the y-axis we mark 10% and 2%, and from 21% we will draw a sloping line, a slanting line. This is a very famous oral question, why this line is slanting. Recall what we had talked about the closed environment. What happens in a closed environment is, as your hydrocarbon is increasing. See, remember y-axis has hydrocarbon. So slowly as you move above this, the hydrocarbon is increasing. Nitrogen has got its share of 78%. Nitrogen is happy. The fight is between oxygen and hydrocarbon. As hydrocarbon is increasing, to maintain that 100% by volume, oxygen has to reduce, oxygen has to decrease. And similarly, or that is the reason that this line is a sloping line and not a straight line. Why this line was a straight line? Because at 11% hydrocarbon content can be variable, nitrogen is 78%, the condition of 100% by volume is satisfied. Moment we come to 20.9% oxygen or 21% oxygen, as and when your hydrocarbon is increasing, to maintain that 100%, oxygen has to reduce. And on this scale, as you go towards the left, oxygen will start reducing. And that is the reason this line is sloping. This is a very, very famous oral question. So what I've done is, I've drawn a straight line here, I've drawn a slanting or sloping line here. Now I mark 10% and 2%, and I join this and I make a smooth curve, although it is not looking smooth, but I will make a smooth curve, and the zone which I get is flammable zone. If at any time during any operation, if the hydrocarbon and oxygen content are in this zone, I am in a big danger. Just to give you an example, let us say I went to a tank called one starboard, for example, one starboard cargo tank. I checked the atmosphere. So I am getting that my hydrocarbon content is 6% and oxygen is 16%. If I plot this in graph, it is coming at this place. This is not what I would want on my ship, because it is very dangerous. One spark, one source of heat, one static electricity dispersal, and the whole ship will turn into flames. So this is how we come to this is how we read this flammability diagram. Let us say I'm giving you a situation. On my tank, when I checked the atmosphere, the oxygen was 3%, which is somewhere in between 2 to 4, and the hydrocarbon was 10%. So when I plot this on graph, the approximate position is this. Now I want to make a man entry. I want to go inside the tank, and without knowledge, recall the example of blindfold which I had given you earlier in this video. What happens is, moment you start ventilating this, the oxygen will rush towards 21% mark. This is the 21 or 20.9% mark. Moment it starts rushing, see what happens. It is crossing the flammable zone. If during this zone something happens, there will be a huge amount of explosion on my ship, which I don't want for sure. What do we do now? How do I reduce this? I will start introducing inert gas. What happens when you start introducing inert gas? Also, one thing to remember, when we talk about inert gas, any gas is an inert gas where oxygen is less than 8% for us mariners. We are not going by the chemical definition of inert gas where we talk about helium, halon, etc. We are just talking simple layman's term. Now what I do? I will put inert gas in this. What will inert gas do? Inert gas will occupy the space and will push out the hydrocarbon. So what happens is, slowly my hydrocarbon will start reducing in tank, because the inert gas is now occupying the space which was occupied by hydrocarbon gas. And slowly I will bring down the hydrocarbon content. Let us say I stop at here. Oxygen will not change, because we will deliver less than 5% of oxygen as per the requirement, so oxygen will be more or less same. Now if I do this, and if I let us say I come to a point which is here, and now if I start introducing fresh air, you see it is just touching this flammable zone, and then it is meeting at 21% of oxygen or 20.9% of oxygen. So which means I need to further reduce it. I will reduce till here, and now if I introduce fresh air, it is passing safe. So what I have done, I have discovered a way by which I can safely gas free my tank. I can safely introduce fresh air, which is 20.9% oxygen in the air. The process of reducing hydrocarbon in an already inerted tank, this process is called purging. One of the most important definition, this point where we are introducing fresh air and it is just touching, this point is known as critical dilution with air. The point where your fresh air, when you introduced, it was just touching this flammable range or flammable zone, is called as critical dilution with air. And this is where it is just touch and go. It is a matter of luck whether or not there will be a fire. So let us recap the definition. Purging is a process of introducing inert gas into a tank which is already in inert condition with intention of reducing the hydrocarbon content. Gas freeing is a process of introducing fresh air into a tank which is in inert condition with the intention of gas freeing. So this is the difference between the two definitions. Let us understand this concept of lower explosive limit, LEL. Why do we need it? What is the purpose? Let us understand in short. 100% LEL means the gas in the tank is at its lower explosive limit, which is nothing but 2% by volume. So a straightforward conversion of 100% LEL is 2% by volume. Okay, this is a mathematical representation. But why do we need it? Remember, on tankers, when we are making tank entry or when we are doing hot work, we are not only, you know, there's a risk of fire, but there's a risk of environment damage, there's a risk of life, there's a risk of property damage, and we don't want any unusual or any unfortunate event on our ship. So, in order to further measure, we have lowered the unit. If you remember, few years ago, we had something known as 1 rupees is equal to 100 paise. What purpose did paise serve? This system is stopped now, but what purpose did paise serve? This paise were more precise values of the rupees. It used to give us more precision. Like in US, we have dollars and we also have cents. Like $1 is equal to 100 cents. If I want to pay smaller amount of money, I will use cent. On the ship, when we are talking about this LEL, we have defined certain limit that if I want to carry out welding inside the tank, minimum LEL has to be 50%. Now, this is just a random value. This is not the exact value. I'm just giving a random value. Let us say I want to go inside the tank and I want to make a man entry. If I'm making a man entry, ideally it should be zero. I don't want any hydrocarbon. But I may say that, okay, 1% LEL, I'm ready to go inside the tank. Although it has to be zero, I'm not saying that at 1% you can enter. But this is what I mean to say, that with more precision, you're able to define better. What happens is, although gas inside the tank may not burn, it is less than 100% LEL. Let us say the gas inside the tank is 90% LEL, which means it is less than the lower explosive limit. There is no chance of fire if you measure this accurately. But at same time, this gas, if you enter, there will be tears coming out of eyes. You will not feel at ease, and there's still risk of your life. So what we're trying to say is, we need more precision, more accuracy, because it is a matter of life. And that is why we have this important concept of LEL, where 100% LEL is equal to 2% by volume of hydrocarbon gas. With this, I have covered the topic of flammability diagram. If you want me to cover any other topic, do let me know in the comment section. I hope you have liked this video. Thank you very much.